Today I got a feedback below my YouTube video. I'd posted one of the videos in my Nothing series, where I speak about life, philosophy of life and thoughts. So this subscriber means well-intentioned. He said, this is not me hating on you or talking bad. I just want to give you a constructive criticism and area to improve. He's saying your content has got repetitive. You keep saying the same thing. Same motivation, same UAE, India, about life, self-improvement. He's saying, I've kind of got used to it. Why don't you start making new content? And he gave me a couple of suggestions. One was, why don't you start a travel blog? Travel around Thailand and talk about different cities and villages and people and their life. Okay. Second one he gave me is, why don't you go visit different restaurants and make a food blog? Third one he gave me is, why don't you visit some of the attractions of Thailand and make a Thailand tourism video? So he gave me a couple of suggestions and said, that will increase the number of viewers, subscribers, engagement. Otherwise, you will not grow much. Okay? The idea is good. All ideas are very good. But generally, the problem is, it's not the idea, it's the implementation. Like, here's what the subscriber didn't think about. Number one is, most important, how much money am I making versus spending, it's time, effort, money, to make these current videos, which are boring. How much money? How much time? How much effort? Okay. Now, I just walked from my house, walked up here, 20 minutes, and I'll go back. Okay. I'll do this 3 times. So, 60 minutes, 1 hour, plus editing, 2 hours. Okay, 3 hours, uploading. So by the time 6 hours are gone, total. Okay. And the revenue that I generate right now is $200-$300 per month. Now, thankfully, I don't depend on YouTube for money, because the money that I generate from YouTube, $200-$300, $500, whatever, now it's declined. My major source of revenue is consulting. Consulting, coaching, training. Now, if I were to start traveling, number one is, which a person doesn't think about, is the logistics of traveling. If I have travel, I have to take my laptop, I have to take my camera, I have to take all my stuff. Second one is, I have to travel by plane, bus, so that will take a couple of days in between. Then I have to stay in hotels, then I have to eat hotel food, then I have to manage my, with this travel, I have to manage my clients, and then there is, I'm away from family, and obviously expenses will shoot up. And then when I do take videos of different places, I have to take permission from those people because the Thai law. Then I have to take permission from the place, the establishment. And then I have to also take permission from the tourism authority because I'm taking someone else's place, or you know, you need permission. You can't just do things. And then where here I'm able to walk three times, three videos. There to make a video, one video, I have to go to a location, place, shoot the video, and that might take 1 week after doing all this, staying in a hotel and everything else. And then I upload the video. Now let's say after uploading the video, I get 1,000 views or 6,000 views or 10,000 views. And the revenue for that 10,000 views is $5 or $6. That one video. Obviously, it's not going to go viral. You're not going to get 1 million people watching that video. And then on top of that, I'll have to start making same kind of videos. So the people who originally subscribe to my channel, who subscribe for Dubai-based news, India-based news, self-improvement, all of a sudden they're getting to see, visit Thailand, and I don't think many people will be interested. See, for example, MKBHD, Dave Tuli, Linus Tech Tips, they talk about technology, computers, and their channel is just about that. They don't change it. Till now, they have not changed. They have 15 million subscribers, 20 million. Now, just imagine if tomorrow Linus Tech Tips and MKBHD start putting a cooking channel. Do you think you would, if you're interested in tech, laptops, watches, gadgets, AI, you're going to watch cooking, how to fry an egg, how to make a chicken satay? You'll say, no, I'm not interested. Imagine a bodybuilding channel. The guy suddenly starts talking about meditation, how to meditate, and starts speaking on spirituality. You think a bodybuilder would be interested? And then let's assume a music channel who speak on music. All of a sudden, they start speaking on DIY, do it yourself, how to fix tables, chairs, broken parts of the house, tiles, leaking, you know, faucets. You think people who listen to music would be interested in that? No. In the same way, the brand loyalty or the followers that I built over the years, that Loy Macedo speaks on Dubai, India, self-improvement, and philosophical thoughts, I'll lose all of them. And now I'm targeting a new audience. What if that audience is not interested? And on top of that, you're telling me about travel. Don't you think there are already enough and more travel channels, travel YouTubers who keep traveling? You can Google search, they already have. And whichever place I visit in Thailand, I'm very sure if you Google search that place's name, they already have minimum 20, 30 videos. So why should my video, which has nobody interested, why should it overtake these guys? In fact, what am I going to talk new that they have not spoken about? Same thing with food blogging. Let's say someone speaks about a Thai dish, say Pad Thai. I want you to Google search or search on YouTube, Pad Thai, Thailand. See how many people have videos. So what makes my channel unique? What, a tattooed guy is eating Pad Thai? Why someone would not want to see a beautiful girl who shows off attractive assets of hers? I mean, why not check her channel? Why not check someone who is actual Thai with professional video editing facilities and a production crew? So now if I were to ask you all these questions, you'll not have an answer. The thing is, when you're not in the industry, it's very easy to lecture and give people advice. Do this, do that. It's like me telling you, see, listen, if you're, suppose you're single, see, listen, have children, 4 or 5, get married, and don't work extras in the office. Let your wife be a housewife. Take care of your wife's family and your family. Sounds like nice advice, no? But then what is your situation? Can you manage? Do you want to get married? Do you want to have children? And let's say you want to do all that. Where is the money? The problem with the unsolicited advice, and that also from people who are not experts in what we do, sounds all nice. It's like, you know, remember when someone is DJing, the person goes to the DJ, hey, listen, hi, how are you? Hey, the DJ says, hi. What do you have this song? You know, we didn't start the fire. He goes, no, 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 no. And the DJ is playing and taking care of 1,000 people. But you come to the DJ and say, no, 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 you know that song? Or the DJ will take, yeah, yeah, sure, sure. Okay, you go. I'll play. Most probably he doesn't play that song. Why? Because number one, he's a DJ. Number two is you don't know jack shit about the pulse of the audience. And number three, maybe you like the song. Nobody else likes the song. See, I understand you being a well-wisher and you mean well. But you don't know jack shit about what goes on into making a video. The effort, the sacrifice, the possibility and probability of even getting 100 subscribers. You have never done it. Very easy for you to talk. And my channel is not an entertainment channel that, oh, today you want food blogging, chal, I'll do food blogging. Tomorrow you want travel, I'll do travel. Then what does my channel become? A channel of everything and anything. Have you seen any product or service in this world that represents anything and everything? In fact, let me burst your bubble by giving a very simple answer. I have a very niche target market. Very niche, specific, small one, where people pay me $230 an hour to $500 an hour for my time. Now, you might say, hey, who the hell is stupid enough to pay you? You're right. In your opinion, who's stupid enough to pay me? But there are people who think otherwise and who look at people like you as stupid. I'm not saying you're stupid, but these people who pay me the money, they have more money than you do. That's why they can spend. And they take my service, personal branding or coaching or consulting, and they pay not once, 4 times, 5 times, 10 times. You might say, they are stupid. Fine, you're the smartest. You're the most intelligent. That's why you're earning millions, no? That's why your career is so successful, right? That's why you are known in the world. Isn't it? Or is that why you behind monitor, keyboard, typing, and nobody cares? It's very easy to give anyone advice. It's like, you know, someone who's sitting in a stadium watching people play cricket or football or a sport and saying, hey, you piece of shit, why don't you hit the ball this way and run this way and do this way? My answer to that is, why don't you go into the field, take the ball and show them what to do? Do you know what to do? Can you do it? In fact, forget that. these athletes are running 90 minutes up and down full speed. Can you run even 5 minutes? Forget 5 minutes, 3 minutes. Full speed. Can you run, tackle the ball? Who'd pay you money for your advice? Who takes you seriously? Nobody. And what have you achieved in life? Who are you? Just another opinion, right? See, I'm not trying to make fun of the people who give opinions, but you need to stay in your lane. It's like having a college kid come up to you and tell you, hey man, you're such a loser, man. You're just earning $4,000, $5,000 per month or $10,000 per month. That's not the way. You're 40s and you're still an employee. You should be an entrepreneur. You should be like Elon Musk earning millions and billions. Will you take the college kid's advice seriously? In fact, you'll ask him, what have you seen of life that you even have the audacity to talk to me? Who are you? What have you achieved? Do something first, cross what I've done, join my line of work, become even better than that, and when you are at 2-3 levels higher than me, then maybe I'll take your advice. It's like having these guys go to the gym few days and suddenly they become experts in bodybuilding and they'll advise everyone. See, listen, when you pull it this way, put your chest up and flex this way, and then the muscle will grow. While they are skinny as fucks, they hardly have, 1-2 weeks experience in the gym. But they'll advise everyone without even knowing what is a brachioradialis, what is a hip flexor, what is the oblique, how to target these muscles. They don't know anything, but they are experts. So I hope this made you understand that, yeah, all this advice is nice and fine and easy and dandy. My challenge to you is this. You create a YouTube channel. Okay? Just create one. Upload 100 videos. 5 minutes each. And show me. Okay, when you finish 100, you tell me. And after the 100th video, let me know how many subscribers you got, how many views you got, how much engagement you got. Then maybe I might take your advice seriously. But you have never made a single video in your life. You don't have any experience. You don't even know how to upload a video. Forget, filling up the name and description and designing a thumbnail and putting up the tags and meta tags, and you don't know any of it. You're not even creative one video. You're trying to give me advice, suggestions, feedback. Come on, man. I know you don't mean bad, but it just clearly shows you're an idiot. So stay in your lane. That's all I say. Stay in your lane. Focus on what you're an expert at. That is, if you're an expert, where you get paid good sum of money. And advise people in your industry, you know, and see how seriously they take your point of view or your suggestion. Or if they don't take your feedback, then why should someone outside your industry take you serious? So think about what I said. Let me know if you think I'm right or wrong. And feel free to comment below. See, the fact, I'll just sum up by saying this. We all get bored of the same videos, the same channel. We all do. I get bored of watching laptop review videos, tech videos. That's why there is always a new channel, a new video, a new content creator. That's why we see different things. Just as you'll get bored of playing a game, or bored of eating one particular dish, or bored of just going to the same place every time. Same way, you'll also get bored of the same content. No? So, unsubscribe to my channel, go to a new channel, find something new, And once you get bored there, then see if you want to come back or move on. That's how life is, no? Tell me, what are you going to do if tomorrow you get married, you get bored of your spouse? Then what you'll do? In fact, forget all that. What about you? Have you changed? Have you evolved? Have you become anything different? Have you done anything different? Do you look the same, act the same, behave the same, earn the same? Then what are you going around lecturing other people here? Think about what I said. And let me know if you think what I said is right or wrong. Alright? Feel free to comment down below. Let me know your thoughts. Too many experts, well-wishers, and too much of unsolicited advice, like a priest giving advice on how to stay happily married and have children. I'm sure he knows a lot about that. God wants you to do like this, like that. You feel like telling the priest, shut the fuck up, man. Anyway, so what I wanted to share. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. It's me signing off. Take care.